So about a month ago, we put out a record called Slappers, Bangers, Certified Twangers, Volume 1. And it is a collection of some of our favorite 90s country songs that we all grew up with. And we recorded this record back in November, and we used it as an excuse to get together and just have some fun in the middle of the pandemic. And we put that thing out at the beginning of May, and about 99% of our fan base got it. They understood it, but there was 1% of our fan base that did not do it. And today, my friends, I'm going to tell you the story about Linda from Twitter. Linda was a normal person, much like you. She woke up on May 7th, checked her email, and she had a surprise waiting for her. American Aquarium has released a new record called Slappers, Bangers, Certified Twangers, Volume 1. And much like many of you, Linda was intrigued. So Linda clicked it and she listened, and guess what? Linda did not approve. How dare her favorite band mess with the sanctity of 90s country music? But instead of being a grown-ass adult and keeping her fucking opinion to herself, Linda decided to get on Twitter. And in 140 characters, she let me know the disdain she had toward our new record. When it was 9:25 in the morning, Linda thought, surely BJ Barham does not have the time this early. Guess what, friends? BJ Barham had the fucking time. I politely responded, first, I have to tell you what she said, actually. Linda's tweet was very, very simple and to the point. She said, I like Faith Hill's version better. And then I politely responded, well, no shit, Linda.
Yeah!
I'm not trying to out-sing four-time CMA Vocalist of the Year fucking Faith Hill. Did you ever think that maybe me and my friends just wanted to get together and have a good time in the middle of a goddamn global pandemic? Thanks for listening, American Aquarium. And so we've been traveling around, we've been playing a couple of these songs each night for people, and we're going to leave you with my grandmother's favorite country artist. This man could do no wrong in my grandmother's eyes. My grandmother said the most debaucherous shit about this man when I was 7 years old, and I had no idea what it fucking meant. And when I got old enough to understand what it meant, it disgusted me to the core. I am so thankful that Sammy Kershaw did not come to Greensboro, North Carolina between the years of 1992 and 1996, because if he had came to the Greensboro Coliseum, my grandmother would have pulled that land yacht of a Buick up, kidnapped him, taken him home, and done unspeakable things to that man. So we're going to leave you with a Sammy Kershaw tune. This is one of the most intriguing songs of the early 90s because he somehow mentions onion rings, chicken fried steak, and the Charlie Daniels of the Toll Bridge in two fucking verses. That's impressive. Gruene Hall, thank you so much for coming tonight. Once again, Morgan Ray, thanks for having the show. And thanks to each and every one of you beautiful motherfuckers for being here tonight. This is a song called Queen of My Doublewide. Well, I met her out at Murphy's restaurant. She said she was from the farm. I remember begging for a country girl. She went pretty well on. Wish that Charlie Daniels with a door crank. I whispered, honey, let's just go on.